Hello everyone, and welcome to Sign of Our Time. My name is Bruce, and unfortunately, I have to drop a truth bomb. You see, in a previous video where we practiced using the factor theorem, life was easy because we were simply given a set of binomials and asked to test which of them were factors. But what if we were asked to factor a polynomial and not given any set of binomials to test? Well, it's time to be brave and to venture into the unknown, but don't worry because I'm going to show you exactly what we need to do. Let's consider a question like this, where we are asked to fully factor x cubed minus 5x squared minus 2x plus 24. Before we even tackle a problem like this, I have to introduce you to yet another theorem, and this one is called the integral zero theorem. Now, I know this sounds menacing, but it is going to help us get a list of factors to test using the factor theorem. The integral zero theorem states that if x minus b is a factor of a polynomial function p of x with a leading coefficient of 1 and all coefficients are integers, then b is a factor of the constant term of p of x. Breaking this down, we first have to check to see that the polynomial function has a leading coefficient of 1, which it does in this example. And then we have to check to see that all of the coefficients are integers, which they are in this example. Now, with these checks complete, we can list all of the factors of the constant term of 24. And don't forget to include both positive and negative values. There are a lot of values listed here, so my advice is always to start testing from the lowest number to the highest number. With that in mind, let's start by testing negative 1 by using the factor theorem, where we could see the answer is 20. And since this value is not equal to 0, we can conclude that b cannot be equal to negative 1. Next, let's test positive 1, which gives us a value of 18. Since this is not equal to 0, we can conclude that positive 1 is not a value of b. So let's move on. We'll test negative 2. And this does give us a value of 0, which means that negative 2 is a value of b. When simplified, it tells us that x plus 2 is a factor of this polynomial. But what about the other factor or factors? Well, at this stage, there are two strategies we can follow to find the remaining factors. The first is to use synthetic division or long division, where we can take that polynomial and divide it by the newly found factor, leaving us with x squared minus 7x plus 12 as the other factor. Since this is a quadratic, we can easily factor it to give us x minus 3 and x minus 4, at which stage we have fully factored this polynomial. The second strategy is just to continue testing possible values of b using the factor theorem. So we'll continue from where we left off. P of 2? No luck. P of negative 3? No luck. P of 3? Yes, this is equal to 0, which tells us that b has a value of 3, and hence that x minus 3 is a factor of this polynomial. At this stage, we just need one more factor. We know this because the degree of the polynomial is 3, while the degree of each of the factors is 1, which tells us that we need one more factor in order for the sum of the degrees of the factors to be equal to 3. So on we go, we're testing negative 4. No luck. And then positive 4, which is equal to 0, which tells us that the value of b is 4 and that x minus 4 is a factor of this polynomial. At this stage, there is no need to test the remaining values since we have found all of the factors of this polynomial. My recommendation would be to use the first strategy since it tends to be more efficient, whereas the second strategy tends to be more time-consuming, especially if there are a lot of values to test. But please remember, you have to use whatever strategy works best for you. As we have seen, the integral zero theorem works hand in hand with polynomials that have a leading coefficient of 1. But what if we are asked to factor a polynomial where the leading coefficient is not equal to 1? More about that in the next video in this series. Why don't you put these skills to the test by trying out this problem and letting me know what your answer is in the comments below. Please let me know if you enjoyed this video, and if you'd like to further support me and my work on Patreon, then please click on the link below to learn more. Well, that's all from me, and I'd like to say a very big thank you for watching.